Hi, I'm John Volker, editor of Green Car Reports, and this is the High Gear Media 2-minute review of the 2011 Tesla Roadster Sport, which we've just finished driving and which, like any Tesla, is hellacious fun to drive. It's hard to figure out when you review a Tesla, what do you compare it to? It's an electric car, but it's a 2-seat high-performance Roadster, so you can't really compare it to a Nissan Leaf or a Chevy Volt, which are 4- and 5-seat hatchbacks. On the other hand, as a performance car, if you compare it to a Ferrari or a Maserati or Corvette or anything like that, you run into the problem that while the stated electric range of this car is 240 miles, if you hammer it, the range goes down considerably. So with a range of maybe 150 miles, it can't travel all day as you could in one of those cars. It is worth pointing out, it will embarrass those cars. The acceleration of this model, the Sport, is the hot rod of the Roadster line. The acceleration, 0 to 60 in 3.7 seconds, there are supercars costing twice that much that it will embarrass. In the end, we come down to some of the pros and cons. The ride is harsh, it's tight inside, it has zero storage space. We think Tesla is unconscionable in charging you for the charging cable you need to make the car run. On the other hand, they've improved the interior since we reviewed it 2 years ago, 2009, and it's still an addictively fun car to drive. We really come down to this car is one of a kind, and it is the first of its kind. This was the car Tesla pioneered the notion that, in fact, electric cars are not silly little golf carts. They can be fun to drive, and in fact, they can be sexy. And 10 and 20 years from now, whether or not Tesla is still with us, we'll look back at this car and say this is the one that did it. So for that reason, we are fond of the Tesla Roadster.